Now, this is the rough diagram of an electric motor, N and S. You can see these are two circular poles. Okay, the surface is made circular. The reason behind it is that we should always have the direction of the magnetic field perpendicular to the direction of the electric current. That, for that reason, we'll have the this circular pole always. Okay, north and south. Two circular poles here. So this is the external magnetic field what we are applying, and ABCD is the coil. The terminals of the two coils, that is this terminal from A, is connected to the commutator split ring C1 and C2. There is a split ring over there which is made into two halves, and these two halves are connected to two brushes B1 and B2. Okay, so now initially from the brush B1 we have the connector going to the positive terminal of a battery, and from B2 we have the connection going to the negative terminal of a battery. Initially what will happen is, like, the current passes from the positive terminal of the battery towards the brush B1, and from the brush B1 it will pass on to the commutator split ring C1. From the commutator split ring C1 it will pass through the coil, enter the coil at points through this end, and it will go in the direction A, B and C and D. So the direction of the, if you see from the top, the direction of the current is going in the clockwise direction. So a south pole is created over there. When a south pole is created, what will happen? This south pole created because of the current through the coil over here, it will be attracted towards this north pole. Okay, so there is a motion. So AB part of the coil will turn down, will go down, and CD part of the coil will go up. Okay, so once it is going up like this, that means AB, now it is horizontal, AB will go down and CD will come up. Once it is coming in this upward direction, it will not stay there. The commutator split rings are attached to the terminals of the coil A. So once this AB part of the coil goes down, this commutator split ring of C1 also goes down. Okay. Similarly, the commutator split ring C2 goes up. Once this goes up like this, because of certain inertia, it will not stay there and it will further rotation continue. So when it rotates, continues the rotation, what will happen is, now C2 will come into contact with B1. Okay. And C1 will come into contact with B2. When C2 is coming into contact with B1, what will happen? That means C2 and DC part of the loop or the coil are on the left side, and now this AB part of the coil is on the right side. Again, the current is going through the same direction through B1 only. Always the current passes through B1. Earlier, the current was going from B1 to C1. Now the current goes from B1 to C2. Now imagine this DC part, D is at A and C is at B, and these two are positions are swapped. So now the current passes through B1, C2, D and C and B and A. Okay, when it continues like that, again what will happen? Again the current is passing in the clockwise direction in the coil, and again at the top side you will be seeing the south pole only. Again there is a rotation. So this continues because of the split ring. The rotation of the coil takes place continuously, and it is possible always for us to pass current in the same direction. So always on the current will pass towards the left hand part of the coil only. That is, right now in the figure it is AB part. So now AB is on the left side. Again afterwards the CD will come onto the left side. So again the current will pass through CD. The CD is pushed down again. So this rotation continues. Okay, once this rotation continues, that means this coil is fitted to a shaft, and because of this current here, there is a circular rotation taking place and the shaft will rotate. So this is how, in simple, how the DC motor functions. Okay, electric motor, generally DC motor like this, it will function.